Maggie from Perusall Support, and I'm here to show you how to turn Perusall on in your course after the Canvas admin at your school has installed it with us. So here I am in my course as a teacher, and it's super simple. I'm going to go to my course, and I'm going to press my course settings. I am going to go to my navigation settings, and I'm going to scroll all the way to the bottom, and as you can see here, I have Perusall 1.3 disabled. Ignore this one because this is our test instance of Canvas and we still have 1.1 installed. So anyway, I'm going to enable this. And as you can see here, it's now in the enabled list of tools and I'm going to press save. And you're going to see Perusall 1.3 is now in my sidebar. Now, before I launch into the tool, I just want to say, if you had a course originally connected to 1.1 integration, say last semester, the first time as a student or a teacher or an admin, the first time you launch into Perusall 1.3, you're going to get an email from us just saying, hey, we're taking your account off of 1.1 and moving it to 1.3. So you just have to confirm that message and relaunch again, and that will take you into a brand new course associated with 1.3. And you will be good to go to start building your course in Perusall. And please note that any of your courses you had before are still in your account. It's the same account. It's just now going to be connected to a new integration. If you ever need to access your old courses, just click My Courses when you're in Perusall and I'll show you. So I'm going to launch this and it's going to take me into my Perusall course and it's going to pop up. Since it's a brand new course, you're going to get a privacy policy that you have to click through, and then you are welcome to start your setup of your course from the Perusall side of things. Now, I already transferred materials over from another course because let's say you were teaching English 101 in the past and you built and did so much work on that in your last semester and you're still teaching that same course this semester. You can always click materials from another course and transfer the materials over into this 1.3 course. Now, I already did that here. So I have built my course in Perusall. And the number one thing I want to next go to is my settings. And I'm going to go to my scoring settings and I'm going to click LMS Grade Sync. Now, this is super important. You want to make sure you set this up right at the beginning, and it really depends on your preference as a teacher. So look at this LMS gradebook column management. As a teacher, you have the option to allow Perusall to automatically create the gradebook columns in Canvas. All the links that you built in Perusall with this setting turned on will push those assignment links into a content area in Canvas and also push over those gradebook columns. Awesome, you don't have to do anything. But if you are someone who wants to manually create each link, you're gonna turn on Perusall creates columns in the LMS through deep links right here. And I'm gonna show you how to create a deep link. It's just important to choose which one you prefer because sometimes people don't realize that the automatic gradebook column setting is turned on and then they make manual links in Canvas and then they have duplicates in their gradebook and in their assignment content area. So right now we're going to go into the deep link mode. So as you can see here in my library, in my assignments, I have it all built here, but I'm manually going to make the deep link in Canvas. I'm going to go to my assignment area of Canvas and I'm going to press add assignment. I can name the assignment name whatever I want. I'm going to say test one. And I'm going to press submission type external tool. And I'm going to look for the Perusall deep link. As you can see here, it says Perusall 1.3 and a whole new window pops up. So much easier than 1.1 setup. And from this drop-down window, I'm going to pick what assignment I want to bring over. So I'm going to bring over assignment one. Press select. And I'm going to make sure always load this tool in a new tab. I'm going to save and publish. So as you can see here, I can test the link to see if it takes me into that assignment in Perusall. And just like that, I'm good to go. So on Canvas's side, you're going to see the assignment area, and you're going to see that I have two assignments here that I have manually built in deep link mode. None of my other assignments have automatically popped up because I made sure that preference was adjusted in my settings in Perusall. So when I go to the gradebook, you're going to only see these two test assignments that I have built. If my settings in Perusall for the grade sync were set to auto, all of my assignments would be pushed over. Their links would be pushed over into the assignment content area, and those grade columns for those assignments would be in the Canvas gradebook. Again, it just depends on what you prefer. And just like that, you are good to go. If you want to know how to copy over a 1.1 course into a 1.3 course, stay tuned.